Last thing on Loma, Dan Rafael tweeted that he said this version, 135 version of Lomachenko, beats the 130-pound version of Floyd Mayweather, which a lot of people think Floyd was probably at his best at 130. Do you agree with that? Because even Terrence Crawford went and tweeted him and said, don't disrespect Floyd like that.
Yeah, that's disrespecting Floyd. Nah, that would have never happened. You know, look, Loma's talented, and Loma's looking that good, but look at the type of opponents Loma's beating. Floyd at 130, that Loma, that Dan Rafael, because he knows Floyd is retired, yeah. And Dan is obviously wants to fucking suck Bob Arum, Loma's balls. Obviously, what else, right? He's saying that because fucking Dan Rafael should know.
They work for ESPN.
Exactly.
And Loma's fighting on ESPN, so they have to, you know, talk him up more. And
come on, Floyd beat Chicanito Hernandez.
Corrales,
you know, all those big fucking names.
I think he got beat one guy that was also named Sosa or something that was like a...
Yeah. And then that Manfredo, Pedro Manfredo, Angel Manfredo. He beat a lot of fucking guys that were up there at 130. Nah, fuck, no chance at all, you know. I think, look, when Loma starts doing that to solid 130 pounders, then we might say, well, maybe he had a chance, but not the way, not beating the guys that he's beating, smaller guys. And maybe he won, because I don't even, you think Chicanito, Corrales, all those guys.
Those fuckers were big.
Wait, exactly. But you think they were in the level of Barchet right now? No.
Barchet
is not in their level, but he's not in their level. And Floyd fucking beat the shit out of him. You know, yeah. Rest in peace, Chicanito, but Floyd really fucking put up.
He was a bad boy that way.
Fucking Loma would never beat Floyd at 130.
What do you think about that? Dan Rafael saying that version of Loma at 130 beats the 130-pound version of Floyd, which a lot of people say that was probably Floyd's best weight.
No. I totally don't agree with that.
No.
That's just them, you know, building up their fighter more. You know, number one pound for pound, Lomachenko.
Yeah, of course.
That's a hell of a...
We know how bad it was. Even Terrence got and tweeted Dan Rafael and told him, don't disrespect Floyd like that. Like, making those kind of...
I agree. That's not a fair analysis of comparison. Fuck. Floyd was a very talented fighter and beat the guys to get the recognition. The opponents that Lomachenko's beating right now are not at the level to claim that status or that greatness. Not yet. Maybe if he beat the other champions there, you know, one by one.
But even those champions are not in the Chicanito level. They're not, bro. What would Corrales and Chicanito do to fucking Berchet? Come on, or to Davis. Come on.
Not the same, huh?
It's not the same. It's like at Walterweight, you know.
Stop at 130 at that time when Corrales, Floyd was there. You know, it was stacked. I mean, you were even there.
That's true.
I think I would have beat Berchet. I think I would have beat Berchet at 130, I think.
Freitas was there.
Casamayor was there.
All of them were like undefeated, like, you know. It was a stacked division.
So who's who?
And they all fought each other.
Yeah.
They all fought each other. They were not bringing up guys from underneath them, you know, from other weight classes to fight. They were fighting each other.
That's true.
It was stacked. It was very different. Very different.
Damn.
Yeah, like I was saying about welterweight, like if we go to the 80s, the welterweights at the 80s and early 90s, way different than probably the welterweights right now.
Can't compare.
You know, it's a big comparison. Yeah. It's big.
Robert, do you have any updates on Brandon Rios and Danny Garcia?
Nah, we haven't repeat that game of one. Not really. We you know, Brandon's training and sparring, but as of now, there's no
Margarito.
Oh shit. There's no comparison.